This is NDTV. And you're watching NDTV Prime.
Hello and welcome to Startup Wednesday. From molestation and sexual crimes to lack of sanitation to the gender wage gap, women in India are constantly faced with roadblocks that limit their access to public spaces. And attempting to solve these problems are several startups, starting with Cash Suvidha, a startup focused on bringing business loans to several entrepreneurs in India. Take a look.
It's been a nightmare. Okay. It's truly a nightmare to raise money. I must have been to at least 10-15 different banks, and some of them agreed to give money and then they didn't give me money because I am single. So that became an issue. Some of them didn't give in money because they said you need to be married.
And Mamta would know. Last year, the 52-year-old founder of a multi-brand retail chain wanted to open up a new store near Delhi's Qutub Minar. But when she applied for the 2 lakh rupee loan she needed to do it, 15 banks closed their doors on her for reasons ranging from her being unmarried to not having enough collateral. It's a sentiment other women echo, such as 22-year-old Twinkle, founder of the furniture retail startup FreeQuip. When she needed 15 refrigerators and washing machines as inventory, she applied for a business loan and faced a similar struggle.
It's beneficial if you have some network, because like when you approach directly to their customer care and when you go through traditional process, then it's become difficult to get a loan. But you do, if you have some network or some connection at a higher level in that organization, then it definitely facilitates the purpose of loan.
According to the 6th economic census, only 14% of businesses in India are run by women, compared to 38% in the United States. And only 4.4% of these Indian businesswomen are financed by a bank loan or government scheme. Banks say that the criteria for male and female applicants are the same. However, some add that women might have a better chance of approval if relatives are involved in the business.
It's not that women are different for women. क्योंकि बिजनेस चलाने के लिए तो मेन एक्सपीरियंस जरूरी है ये है कि अगर उनको हेल्प करने वाले जो मैंने बताया कि उनका फैमिली बैकग्राउंड अच्छा है वैसा है उसी बिजनेस से रिलेटेड है तो उनके फैमिली से उनको मदद मिलती है
एंड व्हाइल देयर आर सेवरल स्कीम्स दैट एम टू हेल्प वुमेन गेट अनसिक्योर्ड बिजनेस लोन्स सम से दिस डजंट ऑलवेज वर्क आउट
रिसेंटली आई वेंट टू अनदर बैंक एंड आई सेड ओके सो नाउ वी हैव मुद्रा लोन We have the government with the women entrepreneur scheme, and they said that's a scheme, but we're not implementing it because if it goes into bad debt, then we are in trouble.
After exploring every possible avenue to get her hands on some capital, Mamta finally got the 2 lakhs she needed from Cash Suvidha, a 1-year-old fintech startup based in Delhi, focused on helping women in both rural and urban India get small unsecured loans for entrepreneurship. Before starting Cash Suvidha, the 47-year-old founder Rajesh Gupta used to be a scrap metal trader and wanted to expand his small metal shop into a bigger one. The personal struggle he faced in getting a bank loan got him interested in the sector's roadblocks. And he realized that while it was difficult for all entrepreneurs, it was much harder for women.
This is a big problem because if today, my daughter is also, if she wants to do business or go, then who will give her a loan?
As a third-party lending service, their interest rates are higher than regular bank loans. Still, they claim their loans have financed over 5,000 SMEs, startups and rural businesses across the country. Lack of access to financial services is only one aspect. Safety and security for women in public spaces is a big issue, and attempting to tackle it in two areas of Delhi is one idea called Surakshit Shahars or Safe Zones. Take a look. A bright orange logo marks 23-year-old Pooja's house in Madanpur Khadar's JJ Colony. While to passers-by it might look like graffiti, for the residents of this low-income slum area in South Delhi, it marks a safe zone for women. 1 year ago, Pooja's became one of several such houses, aiming to tackle crimes against women in the area. A year later, her fight for more security is still ongoing.
जैसे अगर किसी लड़की को किसी लड़के ने छेड़ा और या फिर उसको बहुत दिन से परेशान कर रहा है, वो लड़का नहीं मान रहा है और लड़की को हेजिटेशन हो रही है कि वो घर पे बताएगी तो उसके घर वाले पढ़ाई छुड़वा देंगे या फिर उसे ट्यूशन से आना जाना बंद करा देंगे, तो हम लोग उन्हें सिर्फ बेसिकली समझाते हैं लड़कों को, बट अगर कोई नहीं समझता है तो हम इससे आगे तक इस बात को लेकर जाते हैं, फिर हमें उन्हें पुलिस की धमकी देनी पड़ती है.
Initiated by the non-profit Plan India and the local group CASP, the Safe Zone project turns regular homes or shops into secure areas with residents trained to handle any situation, from harassment to stalking and more. Such as 60-year-old Meena Shukla's grocery store, which is open for vegetables until 8 p.m., but for safety all night.
जैसे स्कूल सुबह लड़कियां स्कूल जाती है, उस टाइम लड़के रास्ते में छेड़ते हैं और स्कूल तक साथ में ही छेड़ते जाते हैं, कुछ कुछ बोलते जाते हैं, ज़बरदस्ती उनको गले में पट्टा लगा देते हैं, ज़बरदस्ती उसके ऊपर पत्थर फेंक देते हैं, हाथ से छू देते हैं, या ऐसा कुछ भी बात होती है तो हम उसके लिए तैयार हैं सेवा में और मुझे इन्फॉर्म कीजिए.
मीना क्लेम्स 2 to 3 सच इंसिडेंट्स आर ब्रॉट टू हर ईच मंथ, व्हिच शी इज इक्विप्ड टू डील विद आफ्टर अ 5-मॉड्यूल ट्रेनिंग सेशन अंडर द प्रोजेक्ट, including confronting the attacker and escalating to the local police if required. Apart from safe house residents, close to 1,000 students from the locality are involved in the project, and they're not the only ones.
We have involved children, I mean girls as well as boys, and other stakeholders like Delhi police or RWAs and all. We have also involved other stakeholders like parents. What we are doing here and why we are doing here, how they can participate in this.
In 2015, 49 crimes against women were reported from this area at the local police station, and 2016 shows them at 52. While the numbers don't reflect improvement, the project's leaders claim it will take at least 2 years for tangible results to show. Still, some girls in the area say they already see a mindset change in their own homes.
कि हम लोग जब यहाँ पे पहले आते थे तो हमारे घर वाले मना करते थे, कहाँ जा रहे हो, क्यों जा रहे हो, और अब आते हैं ना क्योंकि सेफर सिटी के जो हम लोगों ने बैनर वगैरह लगाए हैं और वो सेफर सिटी हाउस वाला लगाया है, तो उसे है ना घर वाले भी समझते हैं कि हाँ अब तो कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं होगी.
जो पहले सा कल हमें बाहर सब्जी मंडी तक जाने के लिए मना करते थे, कहीं किसी घर जाने, आज हम लोग बैंक गए, इतने दूर गए, हम लोग घर से कभी निकले हमें 4 घंटे हो चुके हैं घर से निकले हुए.
High crime rates are why Madanpur Khadar, along with Delhi's Mangalpuri, were chosen to pilot this project, which plans to expand to more of Delhi's vulnerable areas this year. 206 such safe zones in Delhi, and hopefully more to come in the future. Well, it's time for us to take a short break now, and when we're back, we're going to be joined by Ms. Paromita Vohra, an award-winning entrepreneur, writer, filmmaker and curator. Don't go anywhere.